Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can insert and delete multiple documents at the same time using MongoDB. So throughout this series, we've created this very basic project here. You can go ahead and clone this project from the GitHub repository found in the video description, or you can code along from scratch if you know the basics of MongoDB. Now before we get started, I really quickly want to mention that if you need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below. Or better yet, asking the warrenoffkeys Discord server, and someone will try and help you there. So with all that said, let's get started. So within my schemas folder, I have this very basic user schema. It has an email, username, and password as required fields. We're only going to be focusing on those. It does have a messages and name history. Those are just examples for previous videos. We're going to ignore them. We only need to care about these three properties right here. So going back into my index file, we see that we're simply connecting to Mongo. And then here is where we're going to try and insert something. So we are importing the user schema here. Now we can actually use this with the insert mini function. So I can say await user schema.insert mini. And this is going to take an array of objects. So each individual object will be the specific document. I'm going to drag my user schema to the right just so we can see it. And within this first object, we are going to have an email. This can be test1@email.com. Obviously, this is just example data. We're going to have our username. This is going to just be test1. Our password, be password in all lowercase. And then I'm going to go ahead and copy and paste this entire object here two more times. So we're going to have three total users. So after each time, we need to make sure we have a comma, of course, because this is an array of objects. And so you should end up with something like this. Then we can go through and change test1 to test2. And test2 on the username for the second user. The third user, you should do the same. So this should be test3. Username is test3. So now, instead of having to insert three different users, we can now use the insert mini method, which is going to insert all three of these documents at once. So I can go ahead and save this. Going into my console, I can run this with node index.js. We see no errors and the program exited. So going into Mongo, I can click on find to update the documents in this collection. And we see our three users right here. Now, the second thing I want to show you is how to delete multiple documents at the same time using the delete mini method. So here we see that all of our usernames are different. We have test1, test2, and test3. Let's say that we want to delete multiple users at the same time that had test1 or test2 as the username, for example, these two, but we wanted to keep test3 for whatever reason. We can use a delete mini query to actually do that. So I'm going to remove the entire insert mini method call here, and I'm going to use .delete mini. Now this is going to take in an object, and one of the keys in here will be the actual property we need for our schema. So in this case, we want a username. And then this is going to contain an array of strings, and it is a string because our username property right here is going to be a string. And so in here, we can say test1 and then test2. Now, if we want to delete all three of them, we could add test3, but I want to keep one just for demonstration purposes. So here we're going to say delete mini documents, anything that contains one of these two usernames. I'm going to go ahead and save this, and I'm going to run the code. Going into Mongo Atlas, I can click on find. And we see we only have test3 left. So it actually went through and deleted test1 and test2 because it matched the username. And so this is how you're going to insert multiple as well as delete multiple documents within MongoDB. Thanks for watching this MongoDB tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the warrenoffkeys Discord, which will be linked in the video description. If you want to learn more about MongoDB, you can consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.